Namaste, everyone. This is Aga. I'm with Tree of Life Spiritual Coaching. I am today at this beautiful beach in Redwoods National Park. And in this amazing breathtaking scenery, I would like to show a breathing technique to you, a technique that I've been practicing for about 6 months now. It is a Hindu technique, very old. I forgot the Sanskrit name of it, but it is a very powerful breathing process that can help oxygenate your body and help you open up your chakras. As a result of this technique, you will feel a rush of euphoria, positivity, depending on how many times you repeat the exercise. But it is a very powerful technique for those of you who are battling addictions. And maybe you don't know about this, but if you have a lot of oxygen in your body, this makes the brain very happy. So to help you naturally battle depression, addictions, anything that you know causes unhappiness, practice this exercise. And I'm going to demonstrate three different versions of it. Depending on your capacity, you can start with level one, level two, level three, or just go in between. But basically, you're going to take your right hand and put it on your right nostril. And when you take a deep breath, you're going to hold your breath for the count of 16. And you're going to use your left hand to count as you're going through the exercise. You're going to count in your head. And as you have your breath locked, what you do with your stomach, you want to push the membrane into your spine. And that's when the energy rushes forward, upwards, I'm sorry. So basically, it's very important that you do not exhale until you complete the exercise. And during this breathing, internally, you want to chant Wahe Guru. It is not a religious chant. It will help you with the counting. Since it's coming from, you know, Hindu religion, it has certain words already kind of part of this exercise. However, if you want to chant, I love me, or I love nature, that's fine as well. I'm just going to do Wahe Guru, and I'm going to demonstrate three different versions. So the first one is the easiest one. You put your finger on your right side of the nose. You take a deep breath in. So in this version, I only squeezed my stomach once as I was counting and chanting Wahe Guru inside my mind. And then the second version, you're going to do it twice during each count. And we start again. That was the middle difficulty, medium difficulty version. And now I'm gonna demonstrate the one that I do, which is the most strenuous. So you might wanna build up your practice. And we're going to squeeze the muscle 3 times for each count and kind of make sure that the stomach goes all the way as much as you possibly can close to the spine. So let's start with the right nostril. So this is the technique. The third one definitely will take some time. Sorry, I'm a little bit distracted looking at the waves, looking at the birds. But the third one will take a little bit of time for you to build the capacity in your lungs. And I recommend you start with about 10 minutes a day. Choose the level of intensity that works best for you. And you do it continuously. So you do not breathe between the sessions. You only breathe in and out through your nose, and then in and out through the nose. There are no breaks. So whatever feels comfortable, you might feel a little bit nauseated at the time, but this will definitely oxygenate your brain, send a rush of energy into your head. Do it in a place where you feel comfortable. So even if you get a little lightheaded, that you're on the couch, you're on the floor, in your apartment, you're on the bed, somewhere where you can do it without worrying that you can get lightheaded. And you can do it anytime. Yogis practice it every day for up to an hour. I do it maybe 15 minutes a day combined with yoga, sometimes more, sometimes less. But I think if you can build up to a half an hour a day, a few times a week, you're going to feel amazing. And if you need any more description or any more perhaps explanation, feel free to leave a comment and I'll be happy to explain. I think some people call this breath, if I'm not mistaken, a cobra breath. So you might want to look that up as well. But I just want to share this technique and hopefully you will find it useful. It has helped me a lot as I practice and try different things, and then I share it with my clients, with my patients. So I wish everyone happy practicing, lots of love, happiness, peace, and let me know how the practice is going, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. Namaste.